नमस्ते, वेलकम बैक ऑल द ब्यूटिफुल ब्यूटिफुल सोल्स टू वाइट तारा टैरो रीडिंग एंड आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू थैंक ऑल माय व्यूअर्स ऑल माय सब्सक्राइबर्स फॉर शावरिंग सो मच लव एंड अप्रिसिएशन एंड इफ यू हैवंट येट सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल press that bell icon so that you won't miss any of my videos and today we are back with a pick a card reading okay and the topic is being thoughtful for our children okay being thoughtful for our little angels this lockdown has brought so many changes into our lives And the changes are equally applied even to our children, though they are able to express it or they are not able to express it. They are also experienced deep transformations. And that's why there was so much articles, so much news regarding, you know, child psychology connected with the pandemic coronavirus and they being not able to do their regular activities. So as a parent, we have to be very, very patient. You know, we have to be very, very patient. We cannot always impose our opinions on our children. We have to sometimes look at them through their perspectives. Okay. And there are also the number of cases of child abuse have also been increased worldwide during this lockdown time. You know, there are parents, there are family members who torture children, abuse them physically and verbally. So before I shuffle the cards for today's pick a card reading, I prayed to all the angels, to all the guardian angels to come and protect all the children, especially those who have been experiencing the ill treatment, whatever the source. So the children who have been facing this all kinds of abuse, I want all my angels to get deployed to protect the little hearts from getting torn away, you know. So we all need to pray for all the children throughout the world. So let's see what is stored for your child. And if you have more than one child, you can pick definitely individual pile for each of your child, because every children learning perspectives, opinions, everything is different from each other. Even though they are siblings, they have different personalities. So you can go ahead and choose with different piles. So I'll show you the charms. So this is pile one. The name of the flower is Inner Villay. The pink flowers, Inner Villay. On pile two, the name of the flower is Delhinium. The purple flowers, pile two. Pile three, Saxifraga, the beautiful white flowers. Pile four, Rhododendron, the red flowers. It is also the national flower of Nepal. Pile 5, Leontopodium, the beautiful white flower. Leontopodium. Pile 6, Potentilla, the vibrant yellow flowers. Potentilla. And the last pile, Amaranthus, the beautiful red, lustrous red flowers. So you can pause the video if needed, use your intuitions, pray for your little angels and proceed ahead with whichever pile you have chosen and to understand their opinion, to understand what they are attracting, to understand what is the purpose of their attraction and your message to your child through the angelic guidance. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so I believe the choosing part is complete. So before we proceed to the readings pile by pile, there's a small story regarding the guardian angel for children or the guardian angel of children. And if you don't want to listen to this story, you can skip it and directly move with the pile one. But this is very interesting story, and most of you have not known this story. You know, this is a very famous story. It's a folk tale. And I have come to know this story, not only this story, many stories, through my grandmother. So long, long ago, there was a couple and they had 500 children, 500 children. But they could not keep any of them with them forever. They have to send them to faraway places, to their relatives out of their village, because there was a threat of a demoness in the village who used to come and pick the children, and she used to eat them off. So there was so much of tension, so much of mourn created in the village because of this. So none of the villagers would like to keep their children in the village. They would send them to faraway places. And whenever the demoness abducted a child from the village, the whole village used to go under deep mourn, you know, because we cannot imagine something wrong happening to our children, even in our dreams. And if something terrible happens to them in real life, it will tear us apart. So this was a very alarming situation, you know. So all the villagers, they came to know about this enlightened being, Gautama Buddha, Lord Buddha. So they went to him and they requested him, and they narrated them the whole scenario, and Gautama Buddha promised them that this problem will be over soon. So Gautama Buddha went to this the place where this demoness resided, and he took the youngest child of this demoness, the youngest child, the girl, the little girl, and her name was Jilam Mayaju. So Gautama Buddha put her under his bowl, you know. And when the demoness came to know that her child, the Jilam Mayaju, is missing, she went absolutely crazy. She was showing her aggression, and she was like so much fearful and crying and behaving like absolutely crazy. And she was searching her child Jilam Mayaju, and finally when she came to know that Gautama Buddha is enlightened being who has been resolving the problems of everybody around, she went to Gautama Buddha. But as soon as she came near to Gautama Buddha, she started to go off her aggression, and she was crying in a motherhood witch, you know, crying and crying like little baby. Lord Buddha opened his eyes and he asked her, "Why are you crying? Why are you crying? What is your problem?" And she said, "My youngest girl, her name is Jilam Mayaju, and she is missing, and I just want to know whether she is safe, you know." So Gautama Buddha said, "See, you have been doing all terrible things. You were devouring the children of other people, and now when the bad shadow came on to your child, you have been freaking absolutely." And Gautama Buddha said, "If you promise me that you will protect all the children, not only your children, not the children of the village, but all the children of the whole universe, whole world, then only I'll put your child to you on your laps." And she said, "Definitely, I will protect every child. I will see that wherever there is some kind of harm happening to the child, I will go myself and protect them, or else I will send my angels so that they are protected." And since then, she got the authority to dwell around the auspicious places, the Swayambhunath, the temples near, because demons cannot enter the auspicious places, especially demon. There is no entry for demons to the temples, to the churches, you know, to the religious places. But since that day, she was able to dwell around the religious places, and she was designated as the guardian angel for children. And whenever children has any kind of issues, health issues or other kind of, you know, psychological issues or some sickness which is untreated, parents take their children to this guardian angel, and they offer prayers, and they believe that she has the magic to cure all the children all over the world. And the guardian angel is the Ajimadhyaya. So the Ajimadhyaya is the guardian angel for the children. Ajimadhyaya. That's an interesting story. So let's move with the pile one. So let me keep these two piles, other piles asserted. So I'm going to open up all the cards together so that you can understand your child's heart through their hearts, through the pictures on the tarots, and you can relate more to your child's desires and thoughts than me. I'll also try my best to get the vibes of the cards, but please look into the pictures very carefully, and if I am missing something else, you try to capture that. Let's move with the first pile, that is the Incarville Marriage. So what is your child attracting? Your child is attracting a lot of serenity. Your child is attracting a lot of white, the divine light, because I see here the girl. I'm getting the vibes that it is about your daughter. Your concern is about your daughter, and she is like a little angel. She has observed all the divine light, and she, even she, when she picks up things for playing or to wear or to like do anything, she picks up the lighter shades, because white is all over the card, you know. The background is dark, and she is wearing a white frock, white shoes, the flowers at the background are white, and she's holding a white flower. So this child is very, very intuitive, and this child is very, very serene, quiet, and the kind of changes she has been showing after the lockdown, after getting detached from her regular activities, you know, going to school and all that, she has been showing a lot of stability, a lot of balance, and she has been speaking things when in conversation. She has been speaking like a very sensible child, you know. She has brought a lot of changes in her way of talking or way of behavior. So she has been showing drastic changes. Sometimes that might also be a issue of concern for you, you know, like what is happening to my girl, like why she is showing so many changes. Actually, the changes are are the real interest of the child, and this, what we have learned in our lives very later, our children has got the opportunity to learn it at very early age. So we should be very thankful if they are showing positive traits. And she is she is attracting the serenity because her interests are in alignment with her attraction. She will be very good if she is taught meditation, stretching and exercising, because I don't recommend your child will be interested in Western ways of exercising. She will be having more bent towards yoga and towards learning mantras, chanting mantras, or offering prayers to the God, doing worship. And she'll be very good if you will be able to enhance her skills to learn the religious scriptures. She'll be very good at it. She will capture the essence of the religion very soon, because that is her nature. All her energy circles are so much aligned and so much active at this young age. So that is what your child is attracting, and the purpose is conveyed to this card. And this is your soul's message connecting you to your child, you know. It's a soul to soul message. So your soul is saying that this to your child, that to make your decision, ask yourself which way brings me closer to my divine purpose, which way takes me away from it. So this is your message. You keep conveying this message once, twice, thrice to your child, you know. So you decide, you know, because you are so, you understand things so very clearly. So you decide what you want, okay, what brings you into connection with the divine and what takes you away from that divine light. So whichever way you want, I am ready to put you into that way, you know. What I want is your happiness. So this is your message to your child, to your girl, through Angel Vanessa. So that is what we have got for those who have chose pile one, being thoughtful for your child. Okay, now let's move with the second pile, that is this is the second pile, Delhinium. Okay, so what are you attracting for your child, what your child is attracting, what is the purpose, and what is your soul's message to your child? So the first card is, our little babies are also thinking beings. Okay, so your child is very smart, and what vibe I'm getting from this card is your concern is for your son. It could be your daughter also, but what I'm getting vibes from the card is your concern is about your son, and your son is very, very not only attracting for him for her, but he is also, or she is also thinking for other children, you know. She is thinking that, you know, are parents concerned about the changes and the opinions and the things the children are attracting because of all this discontinuity from their regular activities because of this pandemic, you know. Our parents or guardians are able to connect to their children's desires, to their children's opinions, because we are also beings, we are also present here, you know. All the time in the family, people are concerned more about the bigger issues, you know. Nobody will talk about the children issues. Even if they talk in the privacy, they have so many beliefs that we shouldn't be accolading, or we shouldn't be telling all appreciation for a child should be done behind a child, because if you appreciate your child all the time, that might make them overconfident. That's a kind of belief, you know. So even when we discuss about our children, we discuss it in their absence, and your child is very much concerned about their opinion and also about the opinion of other children, you know, what is happening with the children through this pandemic. So there is so much of thinking happening in your child's mind for the children around him and for also himself or herself. And the purpose behind this is energy healing, because your child is here to heal people, you know. That is why he is thinking for himself and also for others. So he has that power, he has that capacity to heal himself, heal herself, and also the children around them. So that is the purpose why they are being so thoughtful about everybody, every child. So that is the purpose, and this is your soul's message to your children. That is about Shanti. So you are being guided through Angel Shanti, that I am the angel of peace. I bring you new tranquility and smoother road ahead. So what you need to make your child believe is that, you know, what you're attracting and what is the purpose of attraction is correct, and I am there to help you. I will help you, you know, to make your endeavors easier. I will create peace in your life, and I'll make all your paths smoother. So whatever I can do from my side, I am ready to do, you know. I'm ready to help, and I'm very happy for, because you have been so thoughtful at this young age that you are not only thinking for yourself, but you're also thinking for the other children all around, like for possibly with whom you are, you can connect. So that's really wonderful for those who have chosen pile 2. Now let's move with the pile 3. Let us see what is your child attracting and what is the purpose and what is your soul's message. What is your role into your child's life? Okay, with the white flowers, Saxifraga. Let us see what is your child attracting. Words do not teach, my life experiences teaches. This is the first card and protection. And the third card is Grace and Antoinette. Okay, so what vibes I'm getting from this card is for whom you have been so thoughtful. Your child is not really very like, they might be in their teenage. That is what I'm getting. And there is a lot of hormonal changes happening into in their body. And they are very well adapting to the changes. And they are, what they are attracting is that they don't want you to get, you getting interfere into their lives for every little things. They are saying that, you know, it's fine. I don't need any teaching from you. Like, if I want something from you, if I want your guidance, if I want your help, then I'll come to you. But before that, you please don't interfere into my personal things. They want their space. You, they want you to give them their space. So, and they want to learn by themselves through their experiences. That is really very common thing, you know, as if you can remember back as a teen to always get into our personal things. We don't want to touch them. We never wanted them to touch. I never wanted my mother to touch my diary, or you know, I never wanted my mother to come in between when I'm talking with my friends or something like that. So there's so much of issue because of the hormonal changes. We have to respect that, you know. And what we have to also understand as a parent is that children are not our property, because I gave birth to my son, to my daughter. They are not my property. I should be very fortunate because they chose to come through me, you know. I can just protect them. I can guide them. I can be their mentor, but I cannot force a monarchy on them, you know. That will be really ridiculous. So your child is attracting to learn through their own experiences, and they want you to be their mentor. And whenever they need guidance, they will look up to you and they want you to help them. But until then, they don't want you to poke into all their little issues. They want you to give them freedom. And they also, the purpose behind their attraction is that protection, because they want to protect you. That's really funny, but because your child is trying to protect you, you know, your child is trying to protect you because they don't want to give more trouble to you. Okay, so by cutting your troubles, they are trying to protect you, and they are also promising that I can protect myself, and I will also protect you. So the purpose of their attraction is protection. They are strong, they are brave. You need to believe them. They can protect themselves, and they are also trying to protect you from you know, because there are so many issues related to children. We are, at least there is a gap of at least 2 decades or almost 2.5 decades between us and our children. So there's so much of generation gap, the things which they discuss, some of the things which we don't even understand or we misunderstand. So our children are trying to protect us, and your child is a warrior. See, look, the picture of a warrior is shown here. So he or she is a warrior. They can protect themselves, and they are also trying to protect their family. So that's really very thoughtful of them. And your children, see, as I told you, this is your soul's message to your child. You should be always telling your children that to help heal this situation, see the other person's point of view with compassion. Yes, so you are a very strict parent. What I'm getting from the card is that you're a very strict parent, and you want to know each and everything happening in your child's life. So how you can console yourself, how you can communicate with your child is that, look, I understand that you need space. I understand that your body is going so much of physical changes. I understand that you are brave. You know everything. You can take right decisions. You understand the difference between right and wrong. But I want you to understand that sometimes when something bothers me, I want you to look into that perspective through my opinions, you know. So you cannot ignore my opinions completely. You have to give respect to my opinions also. When I'm concerned about you, you have to see, you have to try to perceive things through my opinion, you know. So that is the message you should always convey to your child. So that is about the messages those have chosen, pile three. Now let's move. That is the flower. Name of the flower is rhododendron. Yes, this is the national flower of Nepal, and your child is attracting, I get what I think about wanted or not. Oh, your child is a little unhappy, and why he is attracting this is leadership. Okay, and this is your message to your child. See, all the cards have beautiful children, so please look at the pictures carefully. What vibes I get from this first card is that your child is not happy. Your child is not happy because your child is what I get the vibe from the card is your child is very, very active, and your child gets involved into activities which you don't like, or which you think are not safe for them. And they all always enjoy doing things which are very like adventurous, and you don't want them to do that. So you are always holding them for don't do this, don't do that. You are creating mess. You have broken your toys, or you are broken this, you are broken that. And there is so much of complaint happening from your side. So your child is not happy, and he is or she is waiting for this lockdown to over so that they can go back to their schools where they can do full masti and full fun, you know. So your child is not happy. And why your child is attracting this thought, let me read what is written on the card. Whether you want the specific of it or not, it is vibrational essence of subject of your attention that is being attracted, that which you really, really want to get and that which you really, really do not want to get. So when your child is doing things which he or she really, really want to do, he is getting this appreciation which they don't want really, really to come to them. Okay. And why they are attracting so much of adventures, which is becoming cause of disappointment for you, is because they are born a leader, you know. They are born a leader. They will do things very, very different from other children that you must be thinking, you know, children in your family or your sister's children or your brother's children or children in your family. Your child is so much different from them, or he or she does activities which none of the other children do. That is because none of the other children are born to be leader. Your child is born to be leader, so he will be definitely doing things which other children do not do. So that is the purpose of their behavior, and please create a space for them, you know. Let them go outside. If they are creating chaos inside the house, let them go outside in the garden, outside in the ground, and let them do whatever they want. What will happen, you know? There is guardian angel. I just said a story, Ajimadhyaya. She is protecting all the children. So don't worry that your children will be putting themselves in trouble or they'll break their bones. Don't worry about that. The angels will take well care of them. If you always hold them or pull them back from doing what activities interest them, they'll be really very gloomy. So your child is not happy because you're always stopping him or her from doing their favorite activities. So let them move ahead, let them do whatever they want to do. You just be there as a protector, guard them, counsel them, mentor them, you know. You cannot force your opinions. You cannot hold them all the time, you know. Once even the little bird, when the little bird hatches from the egg, the mother bird will protect the baby birds until when they cannot fly. Once they learn flying, the mother bird will tell them that, you know, sky is the limit, go on. So that should be your attitude, and that is the kind of attitude your child is expecting from you. So please do not disappoint them. Okay, so this is your message. When you communicate with your child, put this opinions or put these points to them, and the message is, I'm leading you towards the answer to your prayers. Please listen to and follow the steps I'm communicating through your intuitions, thoughts and dreams. Yes, so angel is saying that whenever your child is doing an activity where which brings your heart to your mouth, like you tell them, you know, I am very scared because as a child I never got into this kind of activities or this kind of adventures, you know, so I want you to take this precautions, you know, please listen to what I'm saying. I will not stop you from what you want to do, but I also want you to consider my words, my opinions. Listen to what I'm saying. If you're going for a bicycle race, wear your helmets, wear your knee pads, and try to take other precaution measures into action. Like, and if you are thinking to climb a tree, be very careful. Do it under the supervision of an adult. If you're going for a swimming, deep water swimming, see that you are having the oxygen cylinder ready and all those things. All those things. I'm sorry. So you keep on telling your child, your kid, that I will allow you to do all the activities which you want to do, which is your interest, but please do it safely, and please inform me, you know, whatever happens, please inform me. If you're going for a tour for 2 or 3 days, keep calling me every 3 hours and tell me that I'm fine, I'm safe, I had my dinner, and it's okay, everything is going fine. So that will give me relief, you know. What I want is your protection. So whatever I'm doing is to protect you. But if your concern is if you are thinking that I am stopping you, my protection is creating unhappiness to you, then I am ready to change. But I want you to strictly take my suggestions into consideration. So that is what I have got for those who have chosen pile. This is 4. Okay, so next let's move with the pile 5. So those who have chose pile 5, that is Leontopodium. Okay, being thoughtful for your child. What is your child attracting? I am a magnet attracting unto myself. Yes, and the purpose of attraction, and this is your soul's message to your child. Whenever you're communicating with your child, you should consider this message. Okay, so what is your child attracting? What I find is that your concern about your child is a girl, a daughter, and I'm a magnet attracting onto myself, and your daughter is very creative. She is very creative, and maybe she is into writing poets, poetry. She writes poems. What I feel from this card, because there is moon and star, and the facial expression of the girl gives me the vibes that she writes beautiful poetry, or she does something creative work which is very, very beautiful, and she is attracting a lot of things, and she is very, very confident about whatever she does or whatever he does, you know. So she is attracting a lot of things to her, and she have been getting involved into a lot of activities since the lockdown. And what is the purpose is to bring in balance, you know. Our children are also psychological beings. There is so much of changes happening in their mind, in their heart, in their thoughts, and to create her own balance, she is trying to do get involved into creative activities, recreational activities, and so you shouldn't stop him or stop her. What I'm getting from the cards, let them do what they are doing, because they are doing it very quietly and very creatively and very beautifully. So they are attracting a lot of beauty, a lot of glamour, and they are doing it to bring balance in their mind and in their heart. So they are doing things which are really, really beautiful and really, really artistic. And as a parent, when you talk to your child, your girl or your boy, whenever she shows her artistic works to you, you should appreciate it. It might be not perfect, but for a beginner, it is really worth accolading. So you should always appreciate your child's poetry or story or whatever the things they are creating to bring in balance in their thoughts and in their emotions. So that is about for those who have chosen the pile 5. And the message from the angel Merilina, which you need to convey to your child, is that you are confused and indecisive because you do not have enough information. Do research or seek expert advice before making a decision. Okay, so I remembered, you know, when I was a little girl, I used to try and make some recipes, new things. And whenever I attempted it for the first time, it was like a complete chaos. If I'm trying to make a sweet dish, it would turn out bitter. And when I showed it to my mother, she used to taste it and she used to say, it's fine. When I made it, the same dish, I just destroyed it completely for a couple of times. So you tried it for the first time, it's fine. You know, you could have done this, or you could have lowered the flame, or you could have keep stirring it. Like that. So she never scolded me for destroying the recipes, for like completely making a chaos in the kitchen. She always encouraged me. She always appreciated me. So you should always tell your child, your daughter, that, you know, your poetry needs more of research, more of depth. Or if she is writing a story, he is writing a story, you should tell them like how to start, begin and end the story, how to give the titles, how to end up with writing morals. So you should polish your child's shine, you know. So as a mother or as a guardian, as a parent, it is your responsibility. So you should bring about these things into conversation when you're talking to your child. You know, the God is not able to present at each and every place in the world. So that's why the God created the mother, so that she is there to give her protection, her divine light and divine protection to her children. So whenever your child is doing things which are amateurish, which are childish, or which are not really nice, then also you should help them so that they can polish their skills, and every attempt they will come out as, you know, better. Okay, so that is what I have got for those who have chose. Move to the pile 6. Let us see what your children are attracting. The first card I have is to the degree I'm happy, I'm successful. That is your child's thought speaker. And the third card is Athena, angel Athena. Okay, so what vibes I'm getting from the card is that your child is very, very good at talking, very talkative and very analytical. Sometimes even you cannot compete with your child when you're into some particular conversation, you know. So your child is very, very open about their desires. You have a very good communication with your child, with your kid, and it could be a son or a daughter. There is a strong communication between you and your child, and your child always tells the little things happening in their life, like every day, if there is something to be worth sharing, they will definitely come and share with you. They will not hide anything from you. That means that you have groomed your child, you have brought up your child in a very well manner. So your child is attracting that to the degree I'm happy, I'm successful. Your child's thought is that if I'm happy, I'm successful. So happiness is what your child is attracting into their life, and they think that the more they are happy, the more they are successful. And the purpose of attracting this thought is because they are good speakers. They will bring insight into the life of others with their speech. You know, it could be singing, it could be something related to the voice, it could be singing, it could be chanting mantras, it could be reading books, it could be just talking, or it could be a quiz contest, which it could be games which need to be vocal games, you know. So your child is attracting this thought because he is a very attractive speaker, you know. There is so much of depth in their voice. So what all they are, their happiness will be perceived through their talking, through their speaking, through their singing, or something which is connected to their vocal. So I also get the sense that their throat chakra is very, very active, very, very full of energy. So let them do what makes them happy. And as a parent, when you're talking to your child, what I see that you are very good at communication. There is a strong communication between you and your child. So you should convey this message to your child, which is being conveyed to you through Angel Ethna. And the message is, it is safe for you to be powerful. You know how to be powerful in loving way that benefits others as well as you. Yes, so Angel Ethna is saying that when you're talking to your child, tell them that, you know, you have got a very magnificent voice, you have got a very so much depth in your voice, and your voice is magical, or your singing is magical, or your way of storytelling is magical. But when you are putting your voice as a medium to convey to others, you should be very careful that you should never use words which will hurt others. Always use sensible words. Always use, always try to convey good messages, good stories, you know, because don't go to the darker sides of the things, whatever you do. If you are singing, you sing melodious songs, good songs, you know, so that when people listen to your song, they feel relaxed, they feel happy, they feel elevated. So you always guide your child, tell your child that through your speaking, through your voice, use it for the positive, to explore the positive sides of the life. Do not harm anyone through your words. So that is that should be your message to your child, which is being conveyed to Angel Ethna. Now let's come to the last card, that is the Amaranthus, beautiful Amaranthus. Those have chose pile 7. Your child is attracting by segment, intending I can expand my time. And the purpose of attracting the thought, and this is the Issa. So what I find is here that your child is a very, very sensitive, very hypersensitive kind of a child, and your child sometimes shows out outbursts of rages, anger, and very moody and a very pampered child, because I see a lot of cushiony clouds or cotton balls, something like that, and your child is, you know, playing. So she might be a girl, what I'm getting from the card, she might be a girl. So yes, your child is very, very choosy. Okay, she might be a fuzzy eater, and she is enjoying her time a lot, like the lockdown time away from school. She might be not want the schools to reopen, you know, so that she can always enjoy her life. She is enjoying, she is happy, she's surprised that this is like something wonderful happening because she has so much tension for her homeworks. She has so much fear of her teachers and the other things, you know, which you can relate better. So your child is very, very happy, and he or she is enjoying their childhood, this lockdown time, thoroughly, and they are doing all kinds of activities. And every time, like maybe they are giving more time to their screen, because here I see something like a television. So when you don't like them spending so much time on screen, they will say that, okay, I will limit my time, and they make a routine. They do things segment by segment, like each day since they get up till they sleep. Sometimes they'll be watching TV, then they'll be playing with you, then they'll be talking with you, then they'll be getting involved into so many activities, maybe, you know, playing with their toys, doing some creative activities, painting, or doing some other kind of art forms, or learning it from the different sources and then trying to do on their own. So your child is very little, maybe 7 or 8 years, that is what I'm getting. And you're very much concerned about your child's future, so as to what will happen to their academics. Will they lack behind in academics? Will that hamper their handwriting or their learning skills, something like that? Because and here, when I look at this card, I find that there was so much of problems during the conceiving period and during the delivery with this child. That is why you have never stopped your child from doing anything which she wanted or which he wanted, and that might have made you into trouble by your family members, that you never stop your child from getting into any kind of activities, good or bad. So you might have been getting suggestions that she is such a fuzzy eater, she should be eating all her vegetables, she should be drinking all her milk, but you never force your child for anything, because you consider as her or him as an angel, because they are just very tender. Because whenever, even when you think of punishing them, when you look at their eyes, when you look at their little hands, little fingers, you don't feel like punishing them. So you have given the whole sky to your child. So your child is exploring each and every part, segment by segment. That's really well parenting. That is my opinion. That is really the way we all should parent our. We all should groom our children. You know, we should give them the sky as the limit. Go ahead, explore your things, and whatever you like, you do it. I am behind you, I am protecting you, I am guiding you. You know, I will never impose my opinions on you. I want to live your childhood to the maximum. Have fun, enjoy, do whatever you want to do. But sometimes, again, you have to make them remind, you know, if you will eat healthy, you will be more energetic. So you like or don't like, try to have a little, you know. So you should always mentoring them, and your role in their life is as a mentor, as a guide. Okay, so that's really very, 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 very good. Those who have chosen pile 7, your child is attracting everything. They are multi-faceted, multi-talented. They are able to execute multitasking, because you have brought up them so well. You have given them the whole floor, the whole sky to explore, and they are exploring each and everything segment by segment, and sooner they will choose their own interest and they will be able to pursue it and come out as winners, you know, outstanding performance in whatever field they choose, they move ahead. So that's really one of the best ways to parent the children. So that's really nice. Those who have chosen pile 3, so everything is on the cards. Okay, so that's really nice. With that, we come to an end for today's reading about our concerns towards our children. So I hope you like the video. So if you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please do subscribe it. And you can follow me on Instagram, because the things which I'm going to share on Instagram, you won't find it on YouTube. And I am waiting for your valuable comments. So we are all concerned about the future of our children, the future of the young generation, future of our nation. So let's be optimistic. Let's always think that whatever is happening, or whatever has happened, or whatever will happen, will be in our favor of our children. So until next time, take care. Bye bye. Astu.